गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक चिल्ड्रन. इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सेक्शंस ऑफ कांग्रेस लाइक मॉडरेट्स एंड रेडिकल्स. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वेरियस लीडर्स लाइक लाला लाजपत राय, बाल गंगाधर तिलक and about Lucknow Pact, which was signed by the Congress and Muslim League. Children, today in the third session of history, chapter number 9, the making of the national movement, from 1870s to 1947, we will discuss about the growth of mass nationalism and the advent of Mahatma Gandhi and about various movements against the British rule. Children, we have discussed in the previous sessions that different groups of people in India like peasants, sepoys, zamindars, kings, they were unhappy with the Britishers' rule in India because of their policies and rules. These people were not happy with the Britishers. Children, now after 1919, the struggle against British rule became a mass movement which involved students, tribals and women in large numbers and occasionally factory workers as well. Children, even some business groups, they also actively supported the Congress in the 1920s. Now, why this was so? Children, the First World War changed the economic and political situation in India. Now, because of huge rise in the defense expenditure of the government of India, the government increased taxes on individual incomes as well as on business profits. Now, because of war, there was increase in military expenditure and also the demand for war supplies, which led to the rise in the prices. Children, obviously, there was a great difficulty for the common people because it increased the prices of the goods. But on the other hand, the business groups, they reaped very good profits from the war. The war created a demand for industrial goods like jute, bags, cloth, rails. And because of this demand of industrial goods, this declined the imports from other countries into India. So, we can say that the First World War was favorable for India because it led to the industrial development in India. Now, Indian industries expanded during the First World War, and Indian business groups began to demand greater opportunities for development. So, children, we have seen that during the First World War, there was huge rise in military expenditure or defense expenditure of government of India, and because of which they increased taxes on individual incomes and business profits. So children, because of rise in military expenditure and demand of war supplies, it increased the prices of goods and services, which definitely affected common people. But children, on the other hand, business groups were able to earn huge profits because of increased demand for industrial goods like jute bags, cloth, rails. And children, because of war, there was a decline of imports from other countries into India. So we can say that during First World War, Indian industries expanded and Indian business groups began to demand greater opportunities for development. Children, now because of war, the Britishers has to expand their army. Now they started pressurizing villages to supply soldiers for an alien cause. Now children, large number of soldiers were sent to serve abroad. Now many of them, when they returned after the war, they returned with an understanding that how Britishers were exploiting the people of Asia and Africa, and they have a desire to oppose this colonial rule in India. And furthermore, children, in 1917, there was a revolution in Russia, and a news about peasants and workers' struggles and ideas of socialism circulated widely, which inspired Indian nationalists also. Children, can you identify Gandhiji in this picture? Okay, he is standing at the center in the row at the back, wearing a coat and a tie. So he is Gandhiji, children, in this picture. This is Gandhiji. Children, in the year 1895, along with other Indians, Mahatma Gandhi, he established the Natal Congress to fight against racial discrimination. And children, in the year 1915, at the age of 46, he arrived in India from South Africa. And it is in these circumstances that Mahatma Gandhi, he emerged as a mass leader. And in South Africa, he led Indians in non-violent marches against racist restrictions. So he was already a respected leader known internationally. And even his South African campaigns had brought him in contact with various types of Indians like Hindus, Muslims, Parsis, Christians, Gujaratis, Tamils, and North Indians, and also upper caste merchants, lawyers, and workers. Children, Mahatma Gandhi spent his first year in India traveling throughout the country, understanding the people their needs and overall situation. His earliest inventions were in local movements in Champaran, Kheda and Ahmedabad. Children, where he came in contact with Rajendra Prasad and Vallabhbhai Patel. And in Ahmedabad, he led a successful mill workers' strike in the year 1918. Children, now let's focus in some detail on the various movements organized between 1919 and 1922. Children, now let's discuss in detail about the movements organized between 1919 and 1922. Children, here we will discuss about Rolat Satyagraha. Children, Gandhi ji gave a call for a satyagraha against the Rolat Act that the Britishers had just passed in the year 1919. Now children, what we understood with the term satyagraha. Satyagraha means political resistance or movement or struggle against the British rule, especially that advocated by Mahatma Gandhi. Now children, what was this Rolat Act? Rolat Act curbed fundamental rights of people in India, such as the freedom of expression, and it strengthened police powers. Children, we have studied about fundamental rights in Civics, chapter number 1, the Indian Constitution. Right to freedom is a fundamental right of every citizen. No person has power, no person has right to take the fundamental rights of citizens. So national leaders like Mahatma Gandhi, Muhammad Ali Jinnah and others, they felt that government had no right to restrict people's basic freedoms like freedom of expression, freedom of speech. So they criticized this act as devilish and tyrannical. Tyrannical means very cruel. This act was very cruel because it was curbing the fundamental rights of citizens. Now here Gandhiji asked people, Indian people, to observe 6th April 1919 as a day of non-violent opposition to this act, and also as a day of humiliation and prayer and hartal, like strike. And children, for this, Satyagraha Sabhas were set up to launch the movement. Children, this Rolat Satyagraha was first all India struggle against the British government. Though it was largely restricted to cities, but it was the biggest struggle, biggest movement against the British rule in India. Children, we have discussed that Gandhiji asked Indian people to observe 6th of April 1919 as a day of non-violent opposition to the Rolat Act, and also to observe this as a day of humiliation, prayer and hartal day or strike day. Now children, in April 1919 there were huge number of demonstrations and hartals in the country. And in return, British government also used brutal measures to suppress these hartals. Now, children, I hope you must have heard about Jallianwala Bagh. Children, Jallianwala Bagh massacre was also known as Amritsar massacre. And on 13th April 1919, people gathered at Jallianwala Bagh to protest against the arrest of two nationalist leaders, that is Satyapal and Dr. Saifuddin Kichliu. And in that Jallianwala Bagh, suddenly a British military officer, General Dyer, like Reginald Dyer, General Reginald Dyer, he ordered troops of the British Indian Army to fire their rifles into a crowd of unarmed Indian civilians in Jallianwala Bagh, Amritsar, Punjab, killing at least 379 people, and many people got injured in that Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Now, children, what we understood with the term atrocities. Atrocities means cruel act of British government which involve physical violence or injury. Now, children, this Jallianwala Bagh atrocities, which was inflicted by General Dyer in Amritsar on Baisakhi Day, 13th April, were a part of this repression. Repression means suppression. Now, children, on learning about the massacre, Rabindranath Tagore, he expressed that pain and anger of the country by renouncing, means by declaring his knighthood. Now, children, knighthood means an honor granted by the British Crown for exceptional personal achievement or public service. Means he was honored by, Rabindranath Tagore was honored by the British Crown, British government, for his exceptional public service, for his achievement. Now, children, during this Rowlatt Satyagraha, the participants tried to ensure that Hindus and Muslims were united in the fight against the British rule. And this was also the call of Mahatma Gandhi, who always saw India as a land of all the people who lived in the country, Hindus, Muslims, and all those other religions. He was keen that Hindus and Muslims support each other in any just cause, in any kind of these problems. So he wants that all the people of India should be united, whatever religion they belong to. They should all be united to fight against the Britishers' rule in India. Children, now after Rowlatt Satyagraha, we will discuss about Khilafat agitation and the non-cooperation movement. Children, first I would like to tell you about non-cooperation movement. Children, this non-cooperation movement was a significant phase of the Indian independence movement from the Britishers' rule. Non-cooperation movement was led by Mahatma Gandhi after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. And the children, main aim of this movement was to resist British rule in India through non-violent means or satyagraha. Children, now the Khilafat issue was one such cause. Children, in the year 1920, the British imposed a harsh treaty on the Turkish Sultan or Khalifa. Children, we have already discussed about Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and after that people were very very angry with the British rule in India. Now also Indian Muslims were keen that the Khalifa be allowed to retain control over Muslim sacred places in the erstwhile Ottoman Empire. And the leaders of Khilafat agitation, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, they also wished to initiate a full-fledged non-cooperation movement. Non-cooperation movement means they also want to fight against the Britishers' rule in India through non-violent means. Children, now Gandhiji supported their call and he urged the Congress to campaign against Punjab Bronx, means Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and against the Khilafat wrong, and demand Swaraj. Swaraj means complete independence for India or self-government in India. Children, we have discussed about non-cooperation movement. Non-cooperation movement was a significant phase of the Indian independence movement from the Britishers' rule. We have also discussed that the main aim of non-cooperation movement was to resist British rule in India through non-violent means or satyagraha. Children, now this non-cooperation movement gained momentum through 1921 to 1922. Children, now we will discuss what happened between 1920 and 1922. Children, thousands of students left government-controlled schools and colleges. Many lawyers such as Motilal Nehru, C.R. Das, C. Raja Gopalachari and Asif Ali, they gave up their practices. Children, British titles were surrendered and legislatures boycotted. People lit public bonfires of foreign clothes. It means they burnt foreign clothes in India. And even the imports of foreign cloth fell drastically between 1920 and 1922. But children, all this was merely the tip of the iceberg. Large parts of the country were on the brink of a formidable revolt. Thank you, dear children. Stay home, stay safe, and take care.